Good morning. This is Avram Shira from Yeshiva Nar Shalom in Jerusalem. This morning we're beginning a new Torah in our daily Patreon class, and so I wanted to bring it out to the public because it's such a central question to every human being on this planet. Why serve God? And we're beginning a new Torah, Torah Yud Chet, the 18th Torah of Likutei Mohran, the masterwork of this master Kabbalist, Rabbi Nachman of Breslov. Now, the Rebbe starts this Torah with a mystical image, a vision that takes place in the Talmud, in Masechet Baba Batra, and he's going to explain it to us esoterically. But that's going to take several pages. We're not going to have time for all of that this morning. But I want to share with you the idea that he begins the Torah after the story. The story is about a rabbi who's on a journey and he sees a treasure box, and the treasure box is floating in the ocean, and so it's surrounded by sharks. And some rabbi jumps into the water to try to get the treasure box, and the sharks want to bite off his leg. This is the story from the Talmud. And so it goes further on to tell us the mystical representation of this little story. But that's going to take time, and that's the kind of thing we cover day by day in our daily class, to understand the symbology of the Kabbalah, to understand its practical relevance to our everyday lives here 2,000 years later. But he begins the Torah with this simple sentence. Listen closely. Da, we should know. L'kol devar yesh taklit. Everything in the world has a purpose. Everything. And everything that has a purpose beyond it. Higher and higher up the ladder of life and consciousness. And he gives an example. Techaret debinyan abay. Why do people build houses? Of course, in order that they can have a place to live. You see behind me here in the dining room of Nahar Shalom is an image of a house. It's called the House of God, the Temple of God. There was once a couple of these a few thousand years ago. Well, we're hoping for a new one. But it takes time to build such a building. But the purpose of building a house is to give a person a place to rest. Protection from nature, protection from other things that we, you know, prefer not to engage. Okay, and then, but what's the purpose of resting? Well, the purpose of resting, of course, is to get energy that we can continue living. And he says, continue serving God. So the whole purpose of rest is to give us strength to serve God. And then he ends this sentence cryptically, and he says, the tachlit of avodat Hashem, well, what is the purpose of serving God? Why do I need to serve God? Why do I need to grow a beard? Why do I do any of the things that people do that serve God? And this is true for Orthodox Jews, of course, because they make that their center and permanent direction in life is to keeping the Torah of God. But it goes true for all other people too, Jews as well as non-Jews. Because you can serve God wherever you are, whoever you are, at every level that you find yourself to be. There's a way to find the purpose and of everything around us, and that leads further on up the ladder of purpose. But why do we serve God? So there's many reasons. And we have to be honest with ourselves. And because, you know, it's a funny thing. People will lie to themselves, but we can't really lie to God. And you know, we lie to ourselves, but we're not even really aware that we're doing it sometimes. And this goes with the Orthodox as well as the secular. Because we think we're doing things for many reasons, and really we have other reasons that are hidden behind the scenes of our mind. So we want to open up our minds. We want to find out, well, why am I really doing this? I'm calling you because I want to help you. Well, maybe I need to help you to feel good about myself. That's not exactly the same thing. Or why do I need to call this person and tell him he's doing the wrong thing? Because I care about him? Or because I want to be a good cop, you know, out there in the big bad world. So we have to always check our reasons for doing things. And if we align our reasons with the true highest reasons, then all of a sudden our path gets straighter. The staircase gets clearer. and more beautiful and more directive and easier to actually follow. Okay, so why do we serve God? Well, a simple reason is because I want the world to come. I want a reward. I want the prize, you know. Now, there are many warnings about this in the Torah and in the words of the rabbis and the Talmud and the Mishnah about serving Hashem because you want the prize. But let's face it. That's why we start out, a lot of people. And the inverse of that, wanting to serve God for the prize, is, well, I'm afraid of what would happen if I don't get the prize. I might end up in a place I don't want to be for a long time. And so we don't know about heaven and earth. We don't know about heaven and hell. But we do know that they've been talking about it a long time, and we're not sure. And so, like, where am I going to put my cards? Who am I going to bet on here in this race of life? So people do it because they're not even sure. They'll serve God just because maybe he's right. Maybe it's the right thing. Now, these are all in the lower, what I would call the lower spectrum of reasons for wanting to serve our Creator. But they're real and they're honest. And we need to be honest and real with ourselves. And then Hashem Elokeichem Emet, God is in truth. So when we are true, then he's close to us, even if our truth is not very flattering. It's not very, doesn't make us very proud to say, well, I'm serving God because I want the reward, you know. That's honest. Okay, but we go up the ladder, there's some other reasons why we serve God. And one is to look good to our kids, to our spouses, to our community, to our leaders. If you're religious and you have a rabbi leader, you want the rabbi, you know, you're joining the team, you want to look like you're a team player, right? So that's another reason. Those reasons. I want to look good. I want to have honor. It's honorable, you know, to look like a rabbi, to act like a rabbi. You get honor from people. Maybe that's why people do it subconsciously. I don't believe too many people do it consciously, but you can kind of, it has a certain vapor, a certain odor to it, you know, the people that are doing it. I laugh because it's not funny, but it is true that people do it. And so it's a low-level reason as well to do it for honor. But you know, a lot of people do a lot of things for honor, right? They want to buy, they wear fancy clothes and they drive rich cars and they have big houses. Well, they have money, but they want to show honor. And they want to receive the honor of their money, for example. Or intelligent people, like I was in university a few times, you know, a few times, right? Over 20 years. And a lot of the professors, they want the honor. They're the head of the class. Their word goes. They're the one who grades, et cetera, et cetera. You understand what I mean. So this is a legitimate thing. It's part of their human makeup, but it's not the highest reason for doing what we want to do. And you could say, well, why serve God? Why do I have to use the highest reason? Well, we have to understand it is, again, a process of refinement to going up this ladder. Now, the higher reasons are, of course, because I want to give God pleasure. I want God to be happy that he created me. I want the divine presence to come out of exile. Now, what is the divine presence? What does that mean, coming out of exile? It means the divine presence is the power of God in revelation. And right now, the power of God is right here in this hall, right here in this city, right here in this country, right here in this world, but it's hidden. So we want to erase the hiddenness. We want to reveal the presence. L'akamat shechinta me'afra, to lift up the shechina means to lift up the presence out of the hiddenness into revelation. So that's a very high thing. And that means that, you know, people are going to raise their eyes. They're going to look up. They're going to sense a change in the reputation in humanity. The humanity is going to have a sense of a higher reputation in the world. And that, of course, is the true reputation of God as a universal, infinite, eternal power for goodness, but also a judge, and also a father, and also a master, and also a advisor, and also a teacher. God is all those things. And the bigger our definition, the more we can receive from Him. Okay, so those are some other higher reasons to serve God. And so really what we want to do is be true and begin. To begin to serve, to begin to do the little things that if you help your spouse in the morning do the dishes, well, you're helping your spouse do the dishes. But maybe if you have the kavana that I'm doing this because God wants me to do it to make my wife feel better so she doesn't have to get a sore back doing dishes, then all of a sudden I'm connecting the purpose to a higher purpose. Right? And then if you give that coin of charity to the little boy, you feel good. You look good in public doing that. Or to the old woman. But maybe it makes them feel better, and then that makes God feel better. And you see how the chain of purpose leads to purpose to purpose continues to rise up closer and closer to the highest realm. So when we do these things, we want to connect them. And our mind is the tool of connection. Our mind is the tool that changes the intention. And your intention is where you drive your car. Your intention is where you drive your soul in this world. And you have many choices and many opportunities to take the simple deeds of everyday life and make them part of the will of God. Which is an amazing thing. You drive to work because you need to earn a paycheck to come home and pay your bills and to feel like, okay, I'm good. I'm okay here. But if I drive to work to get money to pay my bills and to share with others and to help others, you've changed the whole purpose of work. And if you work because I need to refine my character, and if I sit alone in a cave, I'm not going to refine my character that much. But if I'm working with people in an office every day, you're going to refine your character, or you're going to, you know, you're going to be asked to leave one day. So work is about refining character, and being in this world is about that refinement as well. And here today, we're talking about finding the reasons for approaching our Creator, because He wants it. And the highest level, I believe, is because He wants a relationship with us. You know, when you have a child, you don't just leave the child alone after he's born, and you want to relate to him. You want to get to know him. You want to speak to him. You want a relationship, and God wants that relationship with us. And when that happens, there is a unification between the heaven and earth, between man and God, and between all the forces of creation. And that, my friends, brings joy above and below to all the worlds. And we've achieved the purpose. So I want to bless us all to continue this journey, to continue the refinement of our purpose and why we do things, and to examine ourselves honestly, and to reset the lens of our camera onto the highest purpose, step by step. So continue. We'll be continuing our daily classes with Rabbi Nachman on this Torah 18, and we'll be translating it word for word, line for line, and sharing it on our Patreon site. So come join us, and we'll look for you also on all the other platforms, the YouTube, the web Yeshiva, Lighthouse Torah, Mentor Channel, Insight Timer. So there's stuff happening all over, and we're excited to be part of that. All the best. Have a great day.